As a creator, you likely want to record podcasts or interviews, maybe webinars at some point. I want to show you how you can go from recording like this to this. Over the years, my podcast setup has changed drastically, from a lot of gear going into the studio for recording in person to now everything shifting to more online. The one problem I had with doing online recordings, though, quality is just so bad. So the team from Riverside, they asked me if they wanted to check this platform. I downloaded the first episode. I'm just flabbergasted. It's just so good. And that's why I wanted to make this video. So let me show you what my workflow looks like for recording podcasts from pre-production to post-production. Now with Riverside almost at the center of everything. Okay, so before we start to plan anything, I need to tell you how these studios work inside of Riverside. And basically what a studio is, just like here, it's a place to record all of your recordings, or your podcasts, some webinars. This is the one place. And as you can see, I already have one for my podcast called Creator Secrets, but I'm gonna make a new one with you guys, and I'm gonna hop over to the bigger setup because that's where all my gear is. So let's start with a new studio right here. I'm gonna make one for my new channel called Tom's Plan B. It's gonna be audio and video. Now the reason I need this is because I'm gonna have a lot of interviews with experts. For my video essays about climate change. So this is definitely gonna help out with that. Now here I'm just going to do a really quick setup, but I am going to use headphones. We don't want anything to happen to that because we're gonna record the highest quality inside of the platform. So here I have everything selected already. I have my Sony A7 IV, which also lets me record a backup file to the camera, just in case something goes wrong. Now, this one is up on my light stand behind my Mac. It's a bit sketchy, but it gets the job done. As a mic, I'm selecting the Rodecaster Pro with the pod mic, which is gonna be my setup. It's connected to the computer, and it also lets me monitor the audio with headphones on. Here they are. So now that we got all of that, let's just join the studio. Now from here, this is the most important part, is where I can get my invite link. I can just get them at a link, or I can send them an email. It's good to know that people who come in don't have to install anything, but they do have to use Chrome as a browser for this whole platform to work. With the invite, you can select for guests, you can select for a producer who can help you out while you're talking, or you can select audience, in which you can invite up to 1,000 members to just follow along, maybe if you're doing a live podcast, for example, which is pretty neat, or a webinar. Okay, so now that the setup is done, I quickly want to go over something that I do with every interview, and that's sent over a Notion page to my guests so they have an overview of what the whole podcast is going to be about. What I have here are some questions. It helps them be more prepared, and also it helps me to know what this episode will be about. It takes a lot of stress out of the conversations that we're going to have in the future. So what you're hearing and seeing right now is actually being recorded through Riverside. And I just wanted you to hear because it's really high quality. And the way that they pull this off is by using both the video and the audio feed, and they are downloading that to the computers. Meaning if you are recording this with a guest, it will be stored locally. And then while you're having a conversation, it's actually being uploaded as we speak. And then that means that you can also, after maybe a few minutes, already downloads the entire conversation straight from a computer after you finished it. So while you're recording, it might seem that the live quality is just a little bit less, but what's actually happening is that they are recording it locally, so you will keep all of the quality afterwards into your files. Now, you can record up to 8 people right here, and I wish I had that many people available, but what I'm going to show you is how I set this up for recording the highest quality with video and audio. First, in recording is the audio sample rate. For video, it's best to set this to 48 kilohertz. And for the participants' video recording, I like to have the best quality, so I'm gonna choose advanced quality. up to 4K HD. Also, I can load in media that I want to use for during the podcast. And what's interesting here is that I can just load in a video file, which I can then show to react to with my guest. And there's a chat box for you, the guest, the producer, and the audience to interact. So because I don't have friends at the moment, I invited myself in for a chat. Because what I always want to do when I have a guest come in is make sure that I see that the audio is not clipping. And as I can see here, if I really, really act, no, it's still not clipping. So that's perfectly fine. And then you can have just a quick little chat to make everyone feel at ease. And then it's time to record in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, this is the part that I'm most excited about. And I think this is where I also shave off like half the time that I usually spend on a podcast. They have something which is called like an export for Premiere, where they put everything together. They have like a nice timeline and everything into one project file you can download. It's an XML file, so you can just import that into Premiere, load it into a timeline, and you have your entire podcast synced and ready to go. That in itself, for me, is a killer feature. Now, of course, if you're using something else, you can just go through the Riverside platform and download separate video and audio tracks. But I mean, how easy and simple is this? If you're going to edit a podcast, I'm gonna give you a quick tip here. Use color codes. If you hear something interesting inside of your edits, you can just give it a color and you can clip it later with all these different platforms. Something that I really like though is that you can mark clips if something interesting happens. Riverside itself also has a magic editor. So if you know the timestamp, you can just go in here, find the good parts, and then quickly make a clip without thinking too much about design. Okay, so a few things. I uploaded the conversation that you saw throughout this video as an episode on my podcast called Creator Secrets. If you really want to listen to the quality you get from the platform, I would just suggest like listening to that episode. Secondly, if you want to give the platform a go, know that it is free to try out. And the lovely Lisa from Riverside, she actually gave me a code and a link. Code is Tom15. Which you can use if you go decide that this is something for you. Both of those links you can find in the description box below. Now, I mentioned using Notion for planning podcasts, but in this video, I'm showing you how you can also use it to make better videos with better structure and just better storytelling overall. And there's a free template included, no bullshit whatsoever. So I guess I'm gonna see you there.